Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. May I have your attention, please? I will speak, hopefully, only 5 minutes about why satellites matter for connected TV. And having listened to Lorena, I would say, maybe in a more provocative way, why convergence for all will never fly without satellites. Okay, so a couple of statements behind this this introductory statement. First, I think we all agree that the future will be hybrid, the future will be convergence, the future will be connected, whatever you call it, both from a content but also from an infrastructure perspective. So the future will comprise maybe three elements: linear TV, where broadcasting point to multipoint will be the most appropriate. It will be about catch-up TV, which is something hybrid between linear TV and on-demand TV or video on demand or internet, high speed, whatever you call it. And there it will be a combination of push technology with storing capabilities either at the home or at the cabinet, street cabinet. And then last but not least, there will be over-the-top TV, on-demand, whatever you call it, which will be pull, really, point-to-point communication. And I think whatever framework is laid out, it should really be optimal for these three kind of different service or different applications. For satellites, broadcasting is the core strength of our business. You probably know, but more than 50% of the homes are today served by satellites, either direct to home or via distribution to cable head ends or to terrestrial transmitters. There is an increasing bandwidth requirement. Standard digital was requiring 3 megabits, 4 megabits per second. Compression technology improved, high definition came, and required 10 megabits per second. And compression technology will continue to improve, and ultra high definition of 4K TV will be available as of 2015-16 and will require 20 megabits per second despite the better the compression technology. So it's very clear that it's key to have the most efficient delivery platform being used for linear and for catch-up TV, and this both from a cost and from a spectrum use perspective. But satellites are not only important for broadcasting, but they are also relevant for over-the-top TV or for on-demand video. Why? First, satellite helps to offload terrestrial broadband infrastructure networks by bringing bandwidth-hungry linear TV applications away from the terrestrial infrastructure towards the satellite direct to home, and by injecting programs to the terrestrial headends, be it cable headends, be it terrestrial transmitters, be it street cabinets. To give you the one example about Ultra HD TV. So as of 2015-16 and definitely 2020, the standard will be in our European countries Ultra HD TV. 20 megabits per second. 2 TV sets per home. That's not that's probably the normal case. So 40 megabits per second simply must be made available in order to watch 2 stupid linear TV channels. And if this has to be offered by the terrestrial infrastructure, either the European taxpayer will have to pay a lot of money to offer this, or it will simply not be available. So our digital agenda in 2020 will even not allow to have people watching 2 Ultra HD TV channels. Second point, satellite covers really the white spots which are not yet served by terrestrial broadband. That's really for those who today have no broadband digital access. So by using satellites for these white spots, we also avoid that there will be a digital, or that there will be a divide for access to connected TV. Digital divide was a topic of the past. We should be careful that digital divide for access to connected TV will not become a topic of the future. Satellite, another statement, dramatically reduces the cost for rollout of broadband infrastructure, including the use of taxpayers' money. I think that's very clear. So maybe a couple of other things before I conclude, and what I share with you, what I believe that policymakers can do in order to make these things happen. Maybe the one thing is to really say that satellites is an integral part of the communication ecosystem. Very often satellites is seen as simply providing TV to a TV set. Today it's much more. The ecosystem is contribution of news, of information to studios from whatever part of the world is only possible because of satellites. Distribution then from the studios to the homes or to cable headers or to terrestrial transmitters or to street cabinets are also done by satellite. And the consumption of this is no longer restricted to consumption on fixed TV sets. For example, and I'm speaking for ESOA, the European Satellite Operators Association, but nonetheless, if for one second I take the head of my company, SES, we have developed an open standard called SAT-IP, where we convert the DVB signal coming from the satellite into an IP stream that's simply distributed in the home Wi-Fi. So you can use your iPad, you can use any other mobile device, and you watch television in high HD content coming from the satellite without any fixed link between the satellite dish and your device. So that's really showing how we try really to make satellites relevant from a communication ecosystem perspective. Last point before I'm concluding. How can the policymakers or how can the regulators really allow this thing to happen and to have satellites really contributing to the convergence? First, I think you all have to apply technology neutrality in the relevant regulations or legislations. Second, you have to favor open standards. All what we are doing is based on open standards, DVB, HBB, TV, SAT-IP, and so on. Third, there should always be a requirement to have a cost analysis or an impact study on the cost of what is just supported. We, from a satellite perspective, simply find it incredible that taxpayers' money is used to roll out fiber all across Europe. It's simply nonsense. Fourth point, secure access to frequency spectrum. It's clear that satellites needs to continue to be able to use the spectrum in order to help to participate to achieving the digital agenda. And so I hope that altogether we will not forget about satellites. Satellites are easy to be forgotten because we are really a tiny part of the telecommunication industry. And for example, in terms of lobbying here in Brussels, the satellite industry as such probably has 4 or 5 people who are explaining what satellite brings to the table. I believe if I compare it to some people here coming from some telecommunication companies, needless to say that we are not the largest in the world. Thank you.